mis amigas de familia de Porterfield. All our friends and family in Porterfield. This is Katie and Brooke, and we're here to bring you a devotion today. We are here in the village near Quisqueya, in the Dominican Republic, and we are about an hour away from where we are staying. But it has been a blessing to be here. Currently, it's 96 degrees, and we are sweating, but we are sweating joy, and we are super happy to be here. Currently, we just got done being jungle gyms for about 49 kids. It's amazing. As soon as we get here, all the kids come out of their homes into the village square here, as we're calling it, and here in the local church, and it is just amazing. They're so excited to see us and play with us. And so we've been thinking a lot about discipleship this week, and so this is what we wanted to bring to you today, our devotion about discipleship.
So Jesus talks about discipleship in the Bible, and in this particular passage, Luke 9:59, Jesus says to a man, "Follow me." But he replied, "Lord, first let me go and bury my father." Jesus said to him, "Let the dead bury their own dead, but you go and proclaim the kingdom of God." Still another said, "I will follow you, Lord, but first let me go back and say goodbye to my family." And Jesus replied, "No one who puts a hand to the plow and looks back is fit for service in the kingdom of God." So what that passage means is that Jesus' view of discipleship is that it's much more important than the earthly things that we put ahead of it. And, you know, everyone is called to be a disciple and to make disciples. Maybe you weren't called to come here to the Dominican Republic or even to go on a mission trip, but you're called to do something, and he's calling you to do that. And, you know, this passage reminds us that it's not tomorrow that he wants you to start or next week, but he wants you to start today.
That's right. So there's no time like the present, as they say. You know, and we have been thinking about this, the sacrifices that come with discipleship. When we came down here to the Dominican, you know, I personally had my own anxiety and worries, and it was very interesting. Even last night for our group devotional, Matt gave one about worry and anxiety, and it was very interesting to see everyone's perspective. Everyone raised their hand, and everyone had a little bit of anxiety coming on this trip for one thing or another, but to see God's grace and just, it was our calling to be here. I think every single person in this group had a calling to be here for one reason or another. And though we did have to make sacrifices, I know, like, for me, you know, this is all, I only get 1 week vacation, and so I decided to take it on this mission trip. And at first I was like, but now I'm so happy that I did it, and I will do it again. And I know, Brooke, you made some sacrifices as well.
Yeah, absolutely. I have two really young little girls at home, and the thought of leaving them and my husband was so scary, you know, to come down here with the rest of my family still at home. We just moved last week, and everything's a mess, and, you know, just the thought of dropping everything and coming down here, it was a sacrifice for me, but, you know, I just felt God calling me to do this, and I knew there was no way that I could just walk away from that call that I felt, so.
And when you get the call, it's like a very strong pull tug to you. We wanted to read Galatians. We're in Galatians chapter 6, verses 9 and 10. "Let us not be weary in doing good, for at the proper time we will reap a harvest if we do not give up. Therefore, as we have opportunity, let us do good to all people, especially to those who belong to the family of believers." And that had a lot to do with what happened yesterday. I feel like I had that, we were at the Lily House with a few women, and I felt a real strong calling to share my testimony aloud with the group, and I was nervous, but and I didn't do it at first, and then I just almost felt like a head slap in the back of the head, like a gift slap from NCIS. But anyhow, once I wasn't listening, I wasn't paying attention, and then once I started to listen and hear his calling, I truly felt him. He was almost like reaching into me and like pulling me forward, like, speak. And so once I did, I shared my testimony with those women. It was an incredible blessing, you know. And I came down here thinking that we would be trying to help them and disciple them. And though we are, I did not realize how meaningful it would be for them to disciple us. You know, I've learned way more from them and the culture down here than they have probably ever learned from me. And even after I shared my story through all the tears and the sobbing, one woman spoke up and responded to me and gave me some encouraging verses and Proverbs and Psalms. And she also mentioned that she was going to continue to pray for me, and that her story was very similar to mine. And it was just an amazing connection. And all the sacrifices they had to make to get here in that moment was 120% worth it.
Yeah, so, you know, although there are those sacrifices, like Katie said, it's going to be worth it. I read a book not too long ago that talked about how there are earthly rewards, you know, for following God and living the Christian life. We know we have those rewards that are going to be set aside for us in heaven someday. But even on earth, you know, we're rewarded for this. The author of the book I was reading put it in a way I loved. He said, the reward for living the Christian life is getting to live the Christian life. And we both love that because it's just so true. You take that step of faith, and even if it's hard at first, and even if you don't see that reward immediately, you are going to be blessed when you decide to live the way that God has set out for you, because He has your best interest in mind, and He knows what's best for you.
Absolutely.
So, yeah, we love that. The little girls here, we've been playing with them. They love us. They want to play jump rope with us. We brought them things. We brought them, crafts and things to play with, and just stuff like that. And
they're so appreciative.
Yeah, and it's like, even though they don't really have anything to give us in return, it's like you can tell that they want to, and they do everything they can. They hug us, they love us, they want to braid our hair.
They did braid our hair numerous times.
We didn't get to leave without braided hair.
Free beautician.
Yeah, and they just shower us with love like that, and that is
part of
God's love. Yeah, and we got to experience that this week because we were obedient. So.
Absolutely. And the reward is so much more than what we give. And so our encouragement to you this week is don't be afraid to respond to what God is telling you. You know, and we just kind of want to talk about, you know, are you listening? Are you paying attention? How are you drawing nearer to God? And how are you praying to maybe help you become discipleship? I know for me, I'm a little hesitant in making new friends and just stepping out in faith. But Brooke and I think I got a new friend out here, Brooke. And so we've totally connected. And just taking that step of faith and being able to share my pros and cons and my story, we've been able to connect. And that's what it's all about. Now I have a new disciple in my group, which I so much needed. So how can you be a disciple for someone this week?
Yeah, and maybe you don't know, or maybe you've never really been able to hear what God's telling you to do, or maybe you don't know how. And the Bible does talk about that. And we don't have time to talk about it in our devotional today, but I encourage you, you know, to look that up or ask somebody. But what I can tell you is the Holy Spirit, listening for the Holy Spirit. Katie and I were talking about this week, and it's just like listening for a whisper. You know, if someone's clear across the room, they're not going to hear when someone else is whispering. Or you can be right beside somebody and whispering to them, and if they're looking the other direction, they still don't even know that you're whispering. You have to be there, and you have to be listening for it. And that's how it is with the Holy Spirit. You have to draw near to the Holy Spirit, and you'll hear the whisper, and you'll hear God's direction, and He'll give you that discernment if you ask. So that's what we wanted to encourage you to do this week.
Perfect. Yes. So, and until next time, the next time we won't be here in the Dominican Republic, but this is Friday, so we're almost heading home, and so we wish you a very happy weekend, and we'll see you soon.
Adios.